Man, the cops are right outside. They're about to bust me because I'm going to drop these crazy skincare secrets. This is my skincare routine going into 2022. No, for real though, we have a little time to talk. I'm Dylan Greeny. I'm a board certified dermatologist. I'm here to help you get your best skin. So let's go over my skincare routine, which is one you could try and depend on. These are all awesome products that I use every single day. So I'm gonna apply these so you'll see how they go on my skin. We're gonna start with one that's not really practical to do in front of my computer desk, like washing my face. So we'll start with cleansers. And cleansers are important because one, they can include some active ingredients. Otherwise, they just get your skin nice and clean for the products that you're gonna use afterwards to go on nicely, penetrate your skin better. Cleansers are important because they help get rid of the oil, dead skin cells, makeup, pollution from the day. So you can start fresh, apply your skincare products, and they're gonna penetrate well and do the best for you. Now, speaking of the cops and punishment, one of the next things I'm going to talk about would be a great cleanser if you're trying to wash someone's mouth out with soap because it tastes horrible. You ask me how I know. Well, I promise you, if you try this, you'll understand too, because no matter how you use this cleanser, somehow it tends to get in your mouth and you can taste it. It tastes really bad, but you know what? It's still worth it because it's such a great cleanser, particularly for people that have a little bit of mild acne or maskne and they have sensitive skin. So it's really hard when you're trying to treat both of those concerns because people with sensitive skin and use acne products, they tend to dry and irritate. So that can be a problem. So you want something that's pretty gentle. And this next cleanser is really, really gentle. And it could be none other than the Vichy Normaderm Phyto Action. Clocking in at under $20, it makes a great cleanser for someone with mild acne. Now the hero ingredient in the Vichy Normaderm Phyto Action is none other than, of course, salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is awesome because it helps break up oil that's clogged in oil glands and helps to kind of clean out those pores, prevent acne breakouts, or help acne dry up a little bit faster. The key about this is though, the salicylic acid is only at a 0.5% concentration. So it's a very low concentration for the salicylic acid. It comes up into 2% in a lot of products that are over the counter, but that can be pretty drying and irritating. So this is a nice gentle cleanser. And I don't want my cleanser really to like super dry out my skin or irritate it. So this is a great, nice option. Plus you're washing it off. So you're not really leaving that active ingredient on your skin for a long time to continue to irritate and dry your skin. But it's not just salicylic acid that makes the product nice. It also has zinc in it, and zinc can help decrease oil production and make your skin feel less oily. They also throw copper peptides in the mix to help smooth skin texture. Not really sure how much evidence there is out there for that, but that's their claim. Zinc is popping up in a lot of products for helping combat that oiliness. So if you got oily skin, it's something you may want to think about. So when I'm not using the Vichy, I tend to use Dermatologist Special Cleansing Gel. I don't really know how special it is. It's actually, I like it because it feels so bland and boring. It doesn't dry my skin. It's super gentle. There's not a lot of active ingredients, but this just in, it does have quiella saponaria, clearly butchering that, but it has that in it. That's what they say is like basically the foaming agent for the cleanser. It does gently cleanse the skin without irritating, which is awesome. It also has balm mint and lavender in it. I don't know if maybe I have COVID, but you won't smell those things. You won't detect those things. It's not heavily fragranced or anything like that, despite saying it has lavender in it. They basically just kind of put it in there as a soothing, calming agent for the skin. As far as a bland, boring cleanser that may or may not be as special as Dermalogica says that it is, I do love this as an everyday cleanser. It's worth a try if you're looking for a basic cleanser. I will say this one, of course, was gifted to me by Dermalogica, and it is $39, which I think is a little expensive for a cleanser. 8.4 ounces definitely lasts a really long time. I mean, I've been using it every day, and I think there's at least about 3/4 of the bottle left in there right now. So that's a really nice, basic, kind of boring cleanser just to help do the job if you don't need some type of active ingredient in it, like an alpha hydroxy acid or salicylic beta hydroxy acid, something like that. So nice, bland, boring cleanser. And when our skin is clean, again, which I'm not going to do right now on camera because I'm going to get water all over my keyboard and everything else, then once your skin's clean, we can move on to our serums. Because remember how we layer our skincare. You want to cleanse your skin and then apply them thinnest to thickest. So that's what we're going to do today. Now I'm getting older, okay? And we all got questions about anti-aging. So now we're starting to get into a little active ingredient, anti-aging type stuff. So the next thing is a serum that I use every single day. And I've tried a bunch of different brands, and there's a huge variety in price ranges for these products. But the goal with these is they're powerful antioxidants. They help stabilize collagen and they help formulate new collagen. If anybody thinks they know what it is, go ahead and drop a comment below. See if you're right. So this is the first ingredient that I put on my skin after cleansing. And you got to treat this product kind of like a vampire. You got to keep it out of sunlight, okay? The product manufacturers try to do that. Of course, they put it in a nice brown bottle to help protect it from the sun. But this is Dermatology Vitamin C E plus Ferulic Acid. Really nice combination vitamin C product, okay? And as you guys know, there's some really high-end ones. You can see products like this range anywhere from $20 to $160. $70. And this one is around 60 bucks, if I recall. Based on the product ingredients, it's super worth it. This is one of the top three recommendations for skin that I can give somebody. And again, this is a serum, so real thin consistency here. And you use about 3 to 5 drops. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit of that on right now. This again is the first thing that goes on after cleansing our skin. So a few drops here, and basically, ideally, you know, I'm probably wasting a lot of product because I'm rubbing in my hands. You basically just wanna pat this into the skin. It does slightly smell like hot dog water, but hey, you gotta roll with the punches here, okay? You gotta take the bad with the good. This is well worth it. The hot dog water smell fades. You get this from a lot of these vitamin C's that are high end. SkinCeuticals, Maylove, this dermatology one. They all got kind of a little bit of a weird scent to them, but it's super worth it. So it contains L-ascorbic acid, which is the best version of vitamin C. There's a lot of people online, they're like griping and complaining about vitamin C. It's not stable. They're true. Vitamin C is a pretty wimpy molecule. A lot of things interact with it. It does oxidize. It's wimpy. It sucks, but it does act as an antioxidant on our skin, and it's still worth doing every single day. The thing is, you just want to make sure you're using a vitamin C that's L-ascorbic acid between 10 and 15%, okay? In this product, they basically also combined it with ferulic acid. This makes it more stable. So that's another thing you can look for. And again, all the high-end vitamin C's are doing that. Dermatology basically says that their vitamin C is actually stable for 6 months, but do not worry, because if you're using it correctly, you're gonna use the bottle up in about 4 months anyway. So some less stabilized versions of vitamin C are not gonna last nearly as long. A lot of them will last only 1 to 2 months. And the thing you'll notice about this has a, look at that nice, like kind of yellow amber color, okay? This may darken some with time, that's normal. If it gets to be a dark yellow, it's still okay, but it is slightly oxidized, that's what's happening. If it gets to brown or dark brown, basically dermatology says, hey, it's pretty much roached, so you need to get a new one. But again, if you're using it correctly and you're using it every single day, which you should be doing, then you're gonna use it up before it oxidizes anyway. Going back to the vampire thought, vampires probably would benefit a little bit from vitamin C and E. When vampires are around, well, maybe they're still around, but they're probably still around using this every single day. But basically, it's an antioxidant, okay? So when they've studied people actually that put vitamin C on their skin and sunscreen, the people that use vitamin C and sunscreen actually burn less than those that just use sunscreen. Vampires, if you're listening, you should probably consider using vitamin C. Now, if you know me, you know I love LTMD sunscreen. LTMD sunscreen is one of the top recommended dermatologists' like favorite sunscreens. But I recently found that dermatology also makes a great sunscreen, so I've been using it. As you probably know, guys have an aversion to moisturizer, so when you can sneak a moisturizer into a sunscreen, that's a good way for us to get it on our skin. This is a universal broad spectrum SPF that has a moisturizer and also a sunscreen. It's SPF 46, and it also happens to be tinted. So you guys probably know, since you are skin experts, that tinted sunscreens provide blue light protection. And only in recent years have we realized that blue light does play a role in hyperpigmentation, dark spots, age spots, sunspots, melasma, all of that not so fun stuff. The good thing about this sunscreen is it actually will work really great for any skin type. So it's tinted, it's gonna blend in well, it doesn't leave a white cast, despite the fact that it is a zinc mineral-based sunscreen, but it also contains chemical sunscreen agent. It blends really well, it feels great on the skin, and is very hydrating. And this is thanks to basically having a hyaluronic acid-like molecule in it that holds moisture on our skin, keeping our skin nice, plump, and juicy. Feels real good on the skin, and also has vitamin E in it, which is the same thing that we saw in the dermatology, vitamin C, E, and ferulic acid. Good skincare products are gonna contain a lot of the same things, because, you know, the ingredients that are good for our skin are good through our skin, and that's why they make it into these products. But I know you don't believe me. You don't believe me that it's not gonna leave a white cast. So I'm gonna show you, it's tinted. Okay, so let's get a pump here. Let's get a pump of this stuff going here. So look at that, bam. So let's hit it with two pumps. So this is the stuff, little tint to it, okay? It's almost like a little very light foundation. We'll kind of pat it in here. So two full pumps, and it has like a really nice heavenly scent to it. It's really, really great smell, and it blends in great. Doesn't take any effort really to rub in, and it just feels fantastic on the skin. So awesome. It's also a bit cheaper than the LTMD sunscreen, so I think that's a huge benefit. I don't think you can go wrong with the dermatology sunscreen. It leaves you with a nice, healthy, hydrated glow. And again, for a little bit more of affordable price. So it's definitely worth a try if you're looking for a new daily sunscreen. Highly recommend, two thumbs up. So it's getting late at night. You're tired. You're already laying down. And you realize, I didn't do my skincare. Did you get up and do it?
Yes.
Of course you should do it. Get out of bed and do your skincare. Let's talk about the night routine. First of all, repeat your cleanser. Now that your skin is clean, we can do our night routine. So everybody's got questions about under eye bags, dark circles, fine lines and wrinkles around the eyes, thin skin around the eyes. Well, the next product we're going to talk about that I use in my routine is going to be the first smooth landing advanced retinoid eye balm. Okay, so this is actually a new product. This just now made it into my skincare routine. It's brand new and it's an awesome retinoid that you can use around the eyes. So when you open it up, it's basically a balm. It almost looks like chapstick kind of color to it. There you go. You can use this right around your eyes. You know, applying a regular retinoid, which we're going to talk about soon, around the eyes can be problematic because if you get it close to your eyes, a lot of times it is literally going to burn your skin and you're going to be so dry and irritated. So it's really hard to use things like adapalene, tretinoin right around the eyes. And I really wouldn't advise it. I like using a retinoid or retinol that's formulated for around the eyes. This stuff is basically gentle enough to use every single night. And you can just apply a little bit around the under eyes. And that's going to help to thicken up the dermis of our skin, which is that strong supportive layer underneath our skin with thick, healthy collagen, help thicken that up and help to chemically exfoliate, turn over those skin cells. Also help smooth any fine lines, wrinkles, and that. It does pretty much just melt into the skin. There's no fragrance to it. It's very gentle and it does get that nice active ingredient on your skin. There's no stickiness or anything like that with it. It's very gentle. It feels like a moisturizer basically under your eyes.
But no sleeping yet.
We're not done. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to use a retinoid on the rest of our face. Why will we use a retinoid? Do we have acne? Well, it doesn't matter because retinoids are the best thing we can do over the counter besides sunscreen for anti-aging purposes. We're going to do one that I particularly love by a company called Acne Free. Why do I love it so much? Well, because it's super duper cheap and adapalene is a great product to use for anti-aging. So this is Acne Free Adapalene. This is the 1.1% gel and this used to be available only with a prescription, but now you can get it over the counter from a variety of companies. I do love the La Roche-Posay kind, but this adapalene gel is awesome because it's less than $10. And basically, for those of you guys who don't know, you know, adapalene can be used up to 3 times per week starting off. So to use it like Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and you only need a tiny little pea-sized amount to get started, just a pea-sized amount. And how you apply this is you kind of just dot your fingers together and then you dot it on your face, okay? If you want to use a moisturizer before or after this, you can, but all you need is that pea-sized amount. Using more won't help you any faster. It'll only cause you more dryness and irritation. Now, even if you start it 3 days a week, and even if you only use a pea-sized amount, you may actually get a little dry and irritated still when you first start it, and that's okay. That's called the retinization period, and it typically gets better in like 3 or 4 weeks. You should be doing pretty good. Your skin kind of gets used to it and you're doing great. Now, why do we use retinoids? Well, we talked about anti-aging, but what exactly can it help? It can help fine lines. It can help wrinkles. It can help dark spots. It can help skin texture. It can help pores. So with all of those benefits, like you see why you have to be using this. It's such a good thing. The only thing is if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, I wouldn't recommend it, but otherwise go for it. And of course, if you're looking in the store, it's going to be in the acne section. So if you have trouble with acne and breakouts, it's also going to help that. Benefits are seen for acne over 6 to 8 weeks, but for anti-aging, you're going to notice it over years and decades. How I always explain it, if you see somebody that is 45 or 50 and they look like they're 35, it's because usually they're using retinoids and a great sunscreen, good photo protection. So this is really the magic ingredient that people are using in their skincare to help maintain a youthful appearance. Now, again, with the Acne Free or any other retinoid, once you get used to using it about 3 days a week, then you can start increasing it to nightly as tolerated. Some people can only use it 3 or 4 nights a week. As long as you do that consistently, then you're good. Ideally, you're using it 5, 6 nights a week, but some people simply can't tolerate it. Now, I mentioned dryness can be a concern when we're using retinoids, and we've already applied them around our eyes and also on our face. Now, the moisturizer I'm going to talk about next, I have massive respect for this company. It's formulated by board-certified dermatologists and plastic surgeons, and every single product I've tried from them, I loved. They're a little bit more expensive, but I think you're going to really love it too if you try it. The packaging is absolutely awesome, and this is It Cosmetics Bye Bye Redness. So they have a whole Bye Bye line. I did a whole video actually where I only use their skincare products for a complete month. It's been one of my most popular videos on YouTube, and needless to say, I was super impressed. So this is the Bye Bye Redness again, okay? This is a green kind of tinted moisturizer that you can use morning and night, okay? Now, I particularly tend to use this mostly at night, and I'll tell you why. When I got to looking online about the reviews on this product, because I'm always interested in hearing what other people have to say and their experiences about these products too. By the way, if you've used any of these products before, please drop a comment below. Let me know what you think. But basically, when I looked at this product on the It Cosmetics website, there were some people that had reviewed it and they left a low rating saying that it makes them feel greasy. Now, I did notice that. I'm not usually prone to being like bothered by something feeling like too dewy or greasy. I did notice that this product gave me a little bit more shine than other products I've used in the past. Now, I don't really mind that. But when I was on FaceTime with my brother, he did say I look like Papa John.
I've had over 40 pizzas in the last 30 days.
I just took it as a compliment because hydrated skin is happy skin and shows less wrinkles. So we'll get a scoop out of this so you guys can see the consistency of it. It has a light green tint, a little hard to see in this light because the light's so bright. I'm gonna go ahead and put on a little bit of that right now. And this is kind of how we seal in that retinoid and get that all locked into our skin and help to hydrate overnight. So you're gonna wake up with a nice dewy feel from this. And again, if you're worried about any type of greasiness, dewiness, anything like that, then you could just use it at bedtime instead of using it morning and night. But I don't know how much the green tint in this really masks redness, but it sure feels great. It has a real nice smell to it. Does have aloe in it, some cucumber extracts. So it has those things to help kind of soothe the skin and hydrate. So I really love this too. It's become another staple in my skincare. And it also has a soothing colloidal oatmeal in it. And that's actually listed as an active ingredient in some formulations and products now. So that's something that does have a lot of evidence for calming the skin. So it's perfect for those with sensitive skin. So that's my skincare routine. And I sure hope it helps you. If it has, feel free to like and subscribe. You can let me know below if you think I look like Papa John Shatner right now. If I do, or if I don't, it's all good because I'm just here to help you get your best skin. So I'll see you next week.